Taylor, what the hell are you doing running my team?
Look, you've been out of the game for over a year, and in that time, a lot has happened. Notre Dame's caught fire, Accrington Stanley got promoted from Division Two, and oh, that's right, I run your team now.
Oh, and you are crushing it. Running an unsanctioned op so mismanaged that you allowed an apocalyptic bioweapon to slip through your fingers. You're great.
Well, technically, she wouldn't take my call.
No one takes your calls.
Well then, that's that.
No, not that's that. You are relying on your lackluster reputation for me to blow you off, so that I wouldn't be here to challenge your authority.
Well, now that you've finished challenging my authority, the rest of you...
Get yourselves to Angela's Crest.
What she said.
Turn around and get eyes on that plane.
Excuse me, Matilda, but as financier of this operation, I think the expenditure of the jet fuel is up to me.
Turn around and get eyes on that plane.
Who's in charge?
Me.
Matty, without me, there wouldn't even be funding for Phoenix. Hello? Hello? Did she just mute me?
I'm sure it was just an accident.
This is my list of operational requirements. It's new equipment, guidelines, protocols, all in there.
Very well played. You saw this coming.
Yeah. That's why you need me. It's a smart move.
Thank you, Matilda.
You're welcome, Russell.
What is this?
We're trying to be nice. I'm already over it. Did being a war profiteer all those years mess you up? Or were you already messed up, which is why you became a war profiteer? Well, I'll take those odds. Look, if I've learned one thing, it's never bet against... Never mind. Okay, well, I will see you later then.
Why? You have something more pressing?
Yes.
Care to elaborate?
No.
Matty.
I got this.
No, sorry to interrupt. I have the Secretary of Defense on the phone for you.
Yeah. Hey, listen, Mike,
I demand to be here with Miss Weber. I have the clearance.
Exactly how much money did you spend on this circus?
Well, if Codex find a way to wipe out a quarter of the Earth's population, I don't think I'm going to care too much about my bank balance.
Is this going to work?
I don't know.
I want to pull Mac out of there.
It's too soon. They're building trust.
No, he's losing control of the conversation.
Give us the room. You said you did this op at MI6.
I did.
And?
It was successful. Until it wasn't.
I locked one of our best operational officers in with the terrorists in the hope of getting some intel on an upcoming attack.
What happened?
My officer's jugular was sliced open. A shard of broken glass. We missed it.
And now we're gonna put a weapon in the merchant's hands.
But we managed to get enough intel to stop the attack.
Taylor, I know you well enough now to know. You're worried.
Which is why I want to pull Mac out of there.
You're here early. Or should I say late? You know we have techs working around the clock. You really need to go home and get some sleep.
I'm concerned about Angus. I think he may have fallen under Codex's spell.
Why would you say that? Is there something you know that I don't?
No, it's just a feeling.
Okay, well, since we are sharing feelings, I'm concerned about you. Russ, listen to me. Don't mistake your pareidolia for single-minded focus. You're brilliant, but don't get crazy.
I made a lot of mistakes. Lost more to Codex than I care to admit. I just don't want to lose Mac, too.
Well, there's only so much weight any one of us can bear. It's time for next steps.
What did you have in mind?
Let me show you.
What?
Yeah.
Manny, I hope you understand this is your one and only call using the red bat phone.
I understand that, Danny, and I wouldn't waste it. But we need to mobilize our nation's defenses like never before.
A dookie sandwich.
Look, Danny, with all due respect, this is no time for us to stick our heads in the sand. This is a last resort, correct?
Of course.
There's more going on down there than we're aware of. Don't let your trigger finger get itchy.
I didn't give the order to fire.
My orders have been clear all along, sir.
Abort that missile. We've got people on the ground. Thank you, Taylor. You made the right call.
Let me make something clear to you, Matilda. I am not on Mac's side. There's a concrete structure under that ranch house there. Taking out Codex leadership was not 100% guaranteed. Otherwise, I would have let that bomb drop, regardless of Mac O'Reilly.
Well, then thank you anyway. Taylor, stand down!
He's compromised, Matty!
Taylor, stand down! Taylor, tell me you see them.
No! This fire's too big! There's no way of getting in.
Oh, one more thing. Oh, fine. Oh,
is that supposed to be swear?
No, it's all right. Thank you. Your badges. Welcome back to the Phoenix.